الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه كما يحب ربنا ويرضى، وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وبعد. فنوب سكالة الإسلام إمام البخاري أبو عبد الله محمد بن إسماعيل بن إبراهيم ابن مغيرة ابن بردزبة الجعفي البخاري، he collects in his صحيح in the chapter الأرواح جنود مجندة، and also إمام مسلم أبو الحسين مسلم بن حجاج النيسابوري القشيري رحمه الله in his صحيح كتاب الصلة والبر in the chapter الأرواح جنود مجندة. إمام البخاري يا إخوان on the authority of our mother Aisha رضي الله عنها and إمام مسلم on the authority of أبو هريرة رضي الله عنه عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم الأرواح جنود مجندة فما تعارف منها ائتلف وما تناكر منها اختلف. In the tremendous narration of the Messenger of Allah Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, as we said يا أخوان collected by البخاري and Muslim في صحيحيهما on the authority of our mother Aisha and Abu Huraira, where the Messenger of Allah Muhammad said, the souls are like soldiers aligned in ranks. Those who recognize one another, companion and befriend one another, and those who do not recognize one another, then they are in conflict. This tremendous narration, as Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani and Imam al-Nawawi mentioned, ya ikhwan, in the explanation from the noble scholar of al-Islam al-Khattabi, where he says, ikhwan, that the meaning of this narration is that when the souls were created, before they were coupled with the bodies, before they were placed in the bodies, as the word ruh, as the ulama have mentioned, ya ikhwan, ma yakumu bihi al-badan, that which gives life to the body. And the noble scholar Khatib al-Baghdadi, in his tremendous book Al-Jami' li-Ikhlaq al-Rawi wa Tab al-Sami', he mentions the statement, ya akhwan, al-ilm bila amal kal-ruh bila jasad wal-nar bila hatab, that knowledge without action is like a body without a soul and like a fire without wood. So therefore, akhwan, what we understand from this is that the soul is that which gives life to the body. So when Al-Khattabi mentions this, he says before, ikhwan, the souls were coupled with the bodies, before they were placed in the bodies, in the affair of the ghaib, he said that like souls were attracted to one another. So those souls of good, those souls of honor, those souls of nobility were attracted and inclined toward those souls of good. And likewise, ya ikhwan, those souls of evil, those souls of transgression, those souls of innovation and the likes of that were likewise inclined towards one another. And when those souls were placed into the bodies, those individuals, ya ikhwan, who were upon good, they recognized those who were upon good and they inclined towards them, as the Messenger of Allah Muhammad said in the narration. And those souls that were inclined towards evil, then they unite with those souls that are upon evil and disunite with those souls who are upon good. Ibn Qayyim al-Jawzi, rahimahullah ta'ala, he mentions, ya akhwan, a tremendous narration on our mother Aisha, radiallahu anha, ba'da mawtin nabiyyi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, after the death of the Messenger of Allah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. She mentioned, ikhwan, regarding a woman from the people of Mecca. And she was a woman, as it mentions in the narration, ikhwan, kanat tudhiku an-nas. She was a woman with a sense of humor. And she used to make the people laugh, the women laugh, because of her sense of humor and her good conduct and her beautiful character. Wa kanat tadkhul ala Aisha radhiyallahu anha. And she used to enter upon our mother Aisha radhiyallahu anha. One day she entered upon our mother Aisha, and she was with a woman from Ahl Medina, from the people of Medina, with a similar personality. This woman from Medina was also a woman who used to make the people laugh. She was a jovial woman, a woman of easy conduct. And they came in together and displayed such love and such sisterhood that Aisha said to the woman from Mecca, have you known this woman for some time? And she said, no, I have not known her. Rather, we just met. But when we met, we clicked right away. And our mother Aisha said, Sadaqti, you have spoken the truth. For indeed, I heard the Messenger of Allah Muhammad say, Al arwah junudun mujannada. The souls are like soldiers aligned in ranks. And therefore, ikhwan, what we see from this narration, as we say in our language, like souls attract. As we say in our language, ikhwan, birds of a feather. So therefore, when you see an individual walking with the people of innovation, when you see an individual walking with the people of Hizbiyah, when you see a people walking with the people of sin and transgression against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, remember that statement of the Messenger of Allah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Al-arwah junudun mujannada. Those souls are alike. No matter what they may claim out of their mouths, no matter what they may say across their lips, if they walk with the people of evil, if they walk with the people of sin, if they walk with the people of backbiting and slander, then know for certainty, ya akhwan, that they are like those who they walk with. As the Messenger of Allah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Sadiq al-Masduq, he is the one who was truthful and the one who was believed. We mentioned, ya akhwan, after this, the tremendous statement of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud. After mentioning this narration, ya akhwan, al-arwah junudun mujannada, it was the noble companion Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, ya akhwan, he said, إِذَا دَخَلَ مُؤْمِنًا مَسْجِدًا فِيهِ مِئَةُ شَخْصٍ لَيْسَ فِيهِمْ إِلَّا مُؤْمِنْ وَاحِدٍ لَجَاءَ حَتَّى يَجْلِسَ إِلَيْهِ. It mentions, ya akhwan, that if the believer, the true believer, was to walk into a masjid, and there were 100 people in that masjid, and out of those 100 people, ikhwan, 99 of them were hypocrites, and only one of them was a believer, that true believer would keep walking until he would incline towards that true believer, and they would sit together. وَلَوْ دَخَلَ مُنَافِقْ مَسْجِدًا فِيهِ مِيَةٌ لَيْسَ فِيهِمْ إِلَّا مُنَافِقْ وَاحِدٌ لَجَاءَ حَتَّى يَجْلِسَ إِلَيْهِ. And if in another masjid, ya ikhwan, if a munafiq, a hypocrite, walked into that masjid, and there were only 100 people, 99 of them true believers in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and only one of those 100 was a munafiq, was a hypocrite, then that hypocrite would incline, he would keep walking and keep searching until he found that hypocrite, and he would incline towards him. This is the understanding of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, from the kibar of the Sahaba, from the elders of the companions of the Messenger of Allah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Hadi akhwan is the understanding of the ulama of Islam. So therefore, akhwan, do not be surprised. Do not be shocked when you see an individual inclined towards someone from the people of innovation, the people of Hizbiyah. Stop making excuses for that individual. Look back to these narrations that we are mentioning and understand them. For as Fudayl ibn Iyad, he said, that noble scholar Fudayl ibn Iyad, he said, ya akhwan, لا يمكن أن يكون صاحب سنة يمالي صاحب بدعة إلا من النفاق. He said, it is not possible It is impossible for a person of the Sunnah to incline towards a person of innovation except by way of hypocrisy. So if a man is truly a man of the Sunnah, if a man is truly a man upon Salafiyah, then he will incline towards those who are like him. Because the Messenger of Allah Muhammad said, Al-Arwah Junudun Mujannada. The souls, ya ikhwan, are like soldiers aligned in ranks. Those who recognize one another unite and incline towards each other. And those who do not recognize one another separate and are in conflict. And in the second part of this khutbah, ya ikhwan, bi'idhnillah, we will further examine some of these narrations, bi'idhnillah, tabarak wa ta'ala. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله يما بعد. We find, ya ikhwan, in the tremendous narration of Al-Awza'i رحمه الله تعالى, ya ikhwan, يقول الرجل يصاحب أهل السنة ويصاحب أهل البدعة. Someone came to Al-Awza'i and they said to Al-Awza'i, they said, what do you say about so-and-so from the people? He sits with the people of Sunnah. And he also sits with the people of innovation. What do you say, O Al-Awza'i, about a man like this? And Al-Awza'i said, Ya Akhwan, Hadha Ar-Rajul Yurid an Yusawi Bayna Al-Haqqi Wal-Batil. He said, this man, the one who was like this, he wants to make the truth and falsehood equal. This individual, Ya Akhwan, know for certainty that if you find a man, sometimes he sits with the people of Sunnah. And sometimes you find him sitting with the people of innovation. Know for certainty, ya ikhwan, that this individual desires to make the truth and falsehood the same, one and the same thing. Because if he was a man of truth, he wouldn't be able to stand and sit with the people of innovation. Because as the Prophet said, ya ikhwan, he wouldn't incline towards them. He would have enmity towards them. He would be in conflict with them because like souls attract. And therefore the true Salafi, true Sunni, was to sit in the company of the people of innovation. He couldn't stand it. He couldn't take it. He would have to move his body. He would have to move his soul away from those who he has no inclination towards. And this is the sign of the Sunni. This is the sign of the Salafi. You don't have to search around, ya ikhwan, bumbling in the dark, trying to find the answers about these individuals. Look who they walk with. It was said of old, ya ikhwan, لا تسأل عن المرء بعد ثلاث. Don't ask about a man after three things. مدخله ومخرجه ومن يماشي. Don't ask about a man after three things. Who he walks with, who he enters with, and who he leaves with. I don't need to know anything else about a man after those three things, as one of our Salaf said. Ibn Battah, ya ikhwan, he said regarding that statement of Al-Awza'i, rahimahullah ta'ala, hadha ar-rajul la ya'raf al-haq min al-batil wa la iman min al-kufr. He said, this man does not know the difference between truth and falsehood, nor does he know the difference between faith and disbelief. And he said, this is like what Allah has mentioned in his Quran. إِذَا لَكُلَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا قَالُوا أَمَنَّا وَإِذَا خَلَوْا إِلَى شَيَاطِينِهِمْ قَالُوا إِنَّا مَعَكُمْ. As Allah mentions in the Quran, look what Ibn Battah mentions, ya ikhwan. Allah says, and when they meet those who believe, they say, we believe. But when they are alone with their devils, when they are alone with their shayateen, they say, indeed, we are with you. Faking, lying, pretending, feigning to be with the people of Sunnah. But in reality, they are people of innovation. There are people who have hatred for the Salafiyah, who have hatred for the Sunnah, but they intend to enter upon Ahlul Sunnah by a very hidden path, pretending to be with them, ya ikhwan. I mentioned to you, ikhwan, the tremendous narration of Sufyan al-Thawri. Lamma qadim al-Basra, that when Sufyan al-Thawri came to Basra, ya ikhwan, sa'ala an al-Rabi' ibn Sabih. Sufyan al-Thawri, ya ikhwan, he asked about an individual by the name of Al-Rabi' ibn Sabih. Look what the people said, ikhwan. He said, ma madhhabuhu. Sufyan said, what is his methodology? What is this man upon? And the people said, ma madhhabuhu illa sunnah. His methodology is nothing but the sunnah. Look at the tawkid. Look at the emphasis. Look at the stress that they placed upon this man's methodology. They said his methodology is nothing but the sunnah. Ma madhhabuhu illa al-istithna. Nothing but the sunnah. But Sufyan al-Thawri, ikhwan, was from the ulama, the people of knowledge and understanding. He said, ma batanatuhu. Who does he walk with? Who are his companions? Who does he sit with? Who does he walk with? And they said his companions are Ahlul Qadr, the people of Qadriyah, those who deny the divine decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What does Sufyan al-Thawri say, ya ikhwan? For who are Qadri? If those are the people he walks with, then that's what he is. It doesn't matter that you say to me that his methodology is nothing but the sunnah. He can announce that from the top of his voice, from the mountaintop, from the minbar, upon the world wide web. It does not matter. If the man walks with the Qadris, he's a Qadri. If a man walks with the people of innovation, he's an innovator. Al-Awza'i, he said, ya ikhwan, man satara alayna bid'atahu la takhfa anna ulfatahu. Whoever is able to hide from us his innovation, he will never hide his companions. Look to who a man walks with, ya ikhwan. Look to who a man walks with. As the Messenger of Allah Muhammad SAW said, ya ikhwan, al-maru ala dini khalilih falyanzur ahadukum man yukhalil. A man is upon the religion of his companion. Look to those who you companion. So I end this khutbah bi-idhnillahi ta'ala with this reminder. Know for certainty, ya ikhwan, that like souls attract. This is the statement of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the one who speaks from revelation. And when you see a man companioning a people, know he is like them, know he is with them, know he is from them. So when someone comes to me and they say, so and so has a PhD, a doctorate in Aqidah, I say, who does he walk with? When they come to me and they say, mashallah, have you heard his recitation of the Quran? I say, who does he companion? When they come to me, ikhwan, and they say, mashallah, fulan has been giving dawah for 30 years, I say, who does he companion? Because this is what we learn from the sunnah of Muhammad. This is what we learn from the methodology of the Salaf al-Salih. This is what we learn from the Aqidah of Ibn Mas'ud and Aisha and Abu Huraira and other than them, from the companions of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And we are not about to throw that away. Those whom he loves. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make our companionship the people of Ahlul Sunnah was Salafiyyah, and to remove us far from the people of innovation and evil. Wa aqim as-salah.
قد قامت الصلاة، قد قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله.
استو. سد الخلل. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. سبح اسم ربك الأعلى الذي خلق فسوى، والذي قدر فهدى، والذي أخرج المرعى فجعله غثاء أحوى، سنقرئك فلا تنسى إلا ما شاء الله، إنه يعلم الجهر وما يخفى، ونيسرك لليسرى فذكر إن نفعت الذكرى، سيذكر من يخشى ويتجنبها الأشقى الذي يصلى النار الكبرى ثم لا يموت فيها ولا يحيا، قد أفلح من تزكى وذكر اسم ربه فصلى، بل تؤثرون الحياة الدنيا والآخرة خير وأبقى، إن هذا لفي الصحف الأولى صحف إبراهيم وموسى. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. هل أتاك حديث الغاشية؟ وجوه يومئذ خاشعة، عاملة ناصبة، تصلى نارا حامية، تسقى من عين آنية، ليس لهم طعام إلا من ضريع، لا يسمن ولا يغني من جوع، وجوه يومئذ ناعمة، لسعيها راضية، في جنة عالية، لا تسمع فيها لاغية، فيها عين جارية، فيها سرر مرفوعة، وأكواب موضوعة، ونمارق مصفوفة، وزرابي مبثوثة، أفلا ينظرون إلى الإبل كيف خلقت، وإلى السماء كيف رفعت، وإلى الجبال كيف نصبت، وإلى الأرض كيف سطحت، فذكر إنما أنت مذكر، لست عليهم بمسيطر، إلا من تولى وكفر، فيعذبه الله العذاب الأكبر. إن إلينا إيابهم ثم إن علينا حسابهم. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
بسم الله بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. بعد إن شاء الله تعالى, brothers and sisters, before you depart, just a few announcements about the weekend program. Jazakallah khairan, our brothers for inviting us. Our brother Abu Hassan, who will give a talk after Maghrib, inshallah ta'ala, on building the masjid upon taqwa. And as we know that our brothers, walhamdulillah, have reached the goal of purchasing a brand new masjid, we ask that you continue to give for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because even though the masjid is purchased, there's still hundreds of thousands of dollars in renovations that need to be made. So if you don't give your wealth for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala,
brothers, keep your voices down.
If you don't give your wealth for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so they can finish this wonderful endeavor, then the process will take longer. I believe that the bills in this masjid reaches about $10,000 a month. Alhamdulillah, we ask that you give for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so you can have a home of your own. A home that you own. Jazakumullahu khairan. Also, today's schedule is our brother Abu Hassan will give a talk after Salatul Maghrib. Again, the theme is establishing the masjid upon taqwa. Tomorrow, inshallah ta'ala, I believe that the program starts after Salatul Dhuhr with our brothers Abu Zainab Tawfiq, our brother Abu Suhail Anwar Wright, a graduate from the University of Medina, our beloved brother, the Imam of this masjid, Abu Suhaila Umar Quinn, and our brother Abu Hassan Malik. Wa jazakumullahu khairan. Wassalamu alaikum rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Bismillah. Brothers, sisters, just a couple of the local announcements, inshallah ta'ala. Brothers, we're asking kindly, please. Please, brothers, we shouldn't go through this every week. We really shouldn't. All classes for tomorrow, Saturday's classes, needless to say, will be canceled due to this program, inshallah ta'ala. However, the sisters' Quran class, which is held on Sunday, will take place, inshallah ta'ala. So again, the sisters' Quran class will take place after Salatul Dhuhr on Sunday. Also, not to forget the sisters' skating program, which is May the 17th, the Branchbrook Park Skating Arena. So again, make a note of that. The brothers could see Mustafa and the sisters could see Sister Aliyah in reference to that. And also, as the brother, we'll just reiterate, there's a program Sunday in Philadelphia. The imam from this masjid, Umar Quinn, and our brother Malik, who just gave the khutbah, will be the speakers. This is at Germantown Masjid this Sunday. So for those of us who travel, we must support this da'wah, brothers and sisters. So again, that's this Sunday from Salatul Dhuhr to Salatul Isha, inshallah ta'ala. And again, there'll be a class this evening after Salatul Maghrib, and we encourage all of us, as this program is in full swing, to come out and to start to take part in this program, inshallah ta'ala. Zafman Kar, barakallahu fiik. Bismillah, brothers, one more announcement, and this is for our brothers. There's a few, inshallah ta'ala, brothers, keep it down. Please, 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 please. There's a few items that has to be taken care of in the building, in the new property. So we're asking that the brothers be available for 9 o'clock Sunday morning, those that would like to help and to help with this endeavor. Again, we need help to take care of a few things that need to be taken care of relative to us getting this building situated so we can get out of here, get from under this $5,000 rent. So, brothers, we need your help. Sunday morning, 9 a.m., inshallah ta'ala. Zahmikar.